Hello everyone, I am Dr. Ipshita Ghosh, endodontist. So today's topic of discussion is the very important material, that is MTA. M means mineral, T means trioxide, A means aggregate. This is a very promising material in the field of endodontics. So this man is the man who introduced this MTA, and his name is Mahmoud Torabinezet. Remember this name, Mahmoud Torabinezet. Actually, he introduced in 1993 this material, but it got FDA approval in the year 1985, 5 years after he introduced. So why do we need to study MTA? Because it's a very promising material. So until recently, two commercial forms of MTA were available. That number one is ProRoot MTA. Number two is MTA Angelus. Now coming to the composition, in powder of this material, we'll get tricalcium silicate, dicalcium silicate, then tricalcium aluminate, tetracalcium aluminate, ferrite, then calcium sulfate, bismuth oxide. But in the water, we use only distilled water. There is no separate liquid for this MTA. So you have to remember only this powder part, mainly calcium silicate. Okay. Then what are the indications? There are lots of indications, and MTA can be used as root and filling material. Then it can be used as direct pulp capping, then perforation repair. It can also be used as MTA sealer. Then apexification, then root canal obturation also. It's also useful for the troublesome problem of strip perforation, as I have mentioned already, perforation repair. Then you can use it in resorptive defect. What is resorptive defect? Suppose this is the tooth. This is the tooth. There is some internal resorption here inside the root. Then through this canal you can inject MTA in this area, so you can use it for perforating resorption defects. Now what are the contraindication? Contraindication is it cannot be used in obturation of the primary teeth, because MTA it doesn't resorb. It cannot be used for primary teeth, and it also has low compressive strength, so cannot be placed in furcation area. So number one is obturation of primary contraindication, obturation of primary teeth. Then secondly, you cannot use it in furcation area. Why? Because it has low compressive strength, due to low compressive strength. Now citric acid and EDTA final resins are not advocated with MTA sealer. That means before putting MTA, you cannot use EDTA as final rinse. After EDTA rinse, you have to rinse it with either with normal saline or any other irrigating solutions. Now MTA, as I have mentioned, it was given in the year of 1993. So it is you can divide it as original MTA, modified MTA, or experimental MTA. In original MTA, we have ProRoot MTA, then which is actually, you can say, you don't have to remember all this, you can say MTA can be divided as two types, grey MTA and white MTA. This grey MTA and white MTA, there is no difference in their properties, no difference. Only thing is that it is aesthetically not acceptable, whereas white is acceptable. So nowadays white MTA is widely used. Since 2002, tooth colored MTA has been marketed to substitute for grey MTA. Okay. So in a comparative study of white MTA and grey MTA, the biggest changes of all, in fact, occur in concentration of ferric oxide, which was black. Then they have given the magnesium oxide, which is responsible for white color. So this ferric oxide is used for, responsible for black color of the MTA, and this magnesium oxide is used to make the MTA white. Then what are the physical properties? Here I like to mention, previously the setting time was 3 to 4, which was the important drawback for this MTA. Because of the setting time, there was only drawback in this MTA was setting time. Then after that, as time passes, this drawback also has been corrected. So I'll tell you the setting time later on again. Now it has come down to 9 to 12 minutes. So if any question come, what is the setting time of MTA, you can give 9 to 10 minutes. Initially it was pH was 10.2, then setting pH after around 9 to 12 minutes it came up to 12.5, and working time, the mixing time, is only 5 minutes. Then compressive strength of set MTA is 70 MPa, approximately equal to IRM but much less than amalgam. The compressive strength of amalgam is 311 MPa. Remember this point also. So there can be, they can compare the compressive strength of MTA and the amalgam. One more important point is it has low solubility. Then rhodia opacity slightly greater than dentin. So you can easily differentiate in the radiograph. And what is the powder water ratio? Powder will be 3 parts and the water is 1 part. So 3:1 is the powder liquid ratio. Don't confuse in this area. This part is powder part and this part is liquid part. What are the advantages? Advantages are versatile application. It has so many advantages, and it has versatile application. It is biocompatible, bioactive. It has excellent sealing properties. Set in the presence of moisture. This is also one of the very important points. Set in presence of moisture. So in case of periodontal surgeries and all, if we put MTA, surgeons used to initiate bleeding, because through this bleeding there will be setting of the MTA. Then it is less cytotoxic compared to other materials. It has dentinogenic, osteogenic potential. It can form osteoblast, and thus it induces cementum apposition. Then it also facilitates regeneration of periodontal apparatus. What are the disadvantages? Disadvantages are very less. The material is a bit costly. It is technique sensitive. Then delayed setting time, it was earlier, but then now it has been corrected. And it should be prepared just before it's used. As I have mentioned, working time is how much? 5 minutes. So MTA sealer may cause discoloration due to the release of ferrocyan. No known solvent for MTA. Biopure MTAD can potentially dissolve MTA. Therefore, it is difficult to remove from the root canal. Now, final irrigation with sodium hypochlorite. As I have said, EDTA is contraindicated as final rinse in case of application of MTA. So, final irrigation is sodium hypochlorite, which provides alkaline environment. Thus, it is suitable for hydration reaction of MTA. Why this sodium hypochlorite is used? Because it makes the environment alkaline, thus it helps in the setting of the MTA. Okay. So the presence of gypsum is reported to be the reason for extending setting time. So in order to reduce, this is the most important point, in order to reduce the setting time, the effect of accelerators such as sodium phosphate dibasic and calcium chloride are being investigated currently. Now MTA Bio is the one of the commercially available product which incorporates an accelerator of this sort and is promoted as a rapid setting material. So here is the drawback of the MTA has been corrected. Now here this diagram is showing the clinical application of MTA. It is used as root and filling material. Previously, we used to use amalgam, GIC, like that type of material. But nowadays, MTA is the most suitable root and filling material. Then it is also used for apexification. Suppose this there is open apex, so in this area we can put MTA for apexification. What is the advantage over calcium hydroxide? Previously we used to use calcium hydroxide for apexification. Advantage is there, if we put MTA, what happen? The formation of the barrier is very fast. For calcium hydroxide we have to wait for several days. Okay, for MTA it is instant. As I have mentioned, 9 to 12 minutes at the setting time. So it will also create a barrier for apexification within 9 to 12 minutes. Then we can use that as Farkashin repair. But as I have mentioned, as there is the compressive strength of MTA is less, so we generally avoid in Farkashin repair. Then it can be used for perforation repair in the lateral canals, then pulp capping. Okay. So now clinical application, root and filling material. As I have already mentioned, the same water powder ratio, and you should know it should be mixed in glass or paper slab with the aid of a metal or plastic spatula. But there is a special type of carrier for this. I'll show in the last part of the slide the instrument for using, for putting MTA inside the canal. As I have mentioned, MTA sets in the presence of moisture. What are the mechanism of action? MTA caused an increase in the production of interleukin 1 alpha, interleukin 1 beta and interleukin 6 and osteocalcin. Thus it helps in apexification. These are the other materials used for root and filling materials. We no need to go for this in this topic. Then Torabinazid et al. Compared the sealing ability of MTA with Super EBA and amalgam and found that MTA leaked significantly less than amalgam and Super EBA. Thus again it proved that it is a superior material. Then you can use it for caries. So this is all about MTA for today. Thank you.